And here we are again for the fifth episode of my Kerbal Space Program Career Mode playthrough, where today we are going to launch our first satellite. So let's head to the mission control, where we have two contracts that fit this this mission. First one is the first satellite contract from the I always forget the name, from the Career Evolution contract pack. And second one is the contract to orbit Kerbin, so if we look at these two contracts, this will be giving us quite a lot of funds when we complete the satellite. So let's head into the vehicle assembly building. And as you can see, I already have unlocked the Octo, but I think for the first satellite you quite obviously have to build the Sputnik 1. Let's just see, yes, we have antennas. So we are going to take the Sputnik, even though it does not have any SAS whatsoever, while the Octo at least has just SAS in the means of holding the attitude. So if we are... Yep, it will be symmetrical like this, so let's... antennas. And rotate them about like this, I think. Yeah, it's looking good. And I have built similar crafts like this before, which you can download. We only have a stack separator at this very small size, and you can download it or something similar from the Steam Workshop, where it is named, I think, just Sputnik or Probobodine Sputnik, something like that. So what we need too is the reaction wheel in order to keep it stable, and some batteries to make sure that it doesn't run out of electricity during the ascent. And I think we already have the payload fairing, because I moved it down by one or two test tree nodes. So let's build the aerodynamic fairing about like this. Stage the two together. And even though we already have liquid-fueled engines, I am quite, or actually I'm not confident, because I already tried it. I do know that we can build this rocket entirely with solid rocket motors. So wait, that's the big one. Like this. And this uppermost stage will only be fired in the vacuum of space, so it doesn't need any stabilizers, but the middle stage will still fire in the atmosphere, so it needs some aerodynamic fins for stability. Let's just check. It is looking good. Okay, the Science Junior suborbital thing also was looking good in the VAB when you activated this information, and in the end it was not. But anyway, I have tried this rocket before, so obviously at the lower stage we have to build some larger fins like this, which also have some control surfaces. And yeah, it's looking good, so let's name it Sputnik 1. And even though in the last episode I actually have found a way to fuel the the Kerbal construction time mod, obviously we are not going to cheat now. So building time will be 15 days. So build it. Leave the VAB. Do not save. We do not have any upgrade points to spend. So, close. Go to the VAB. Remove the alarm and warp to complete. 15 days. So the vessel is complete and roll out. And again, warp about 1 hour. So here we are going to launch. I forgot to stop recording during the loading, which at the last video caused the video files to get corrupted. So I hope not to forget it again in case the game crashes during loading. Anyway, no SIS to activate. Staging is looking good, so let's go. Starting to your esports in order to commence the gravity turn or initiate the gravity turn. Down here. So let's stage, which hopefully will push us into space, but it looks like it does. This is interesting. This is not supposed to happen, that the aerodynamic effects suddenly disappear. But I guess that is what you have to expect with Kerbal Space That's what you have to expect with Kerbal Space Program with a ton of mods installed. So once we are in space, we can rearrange the staging that we just jettison to the lower stage without actually firing up the upper stage. So the apoapsis is quite high. We cannot warp to some point of our flight because we do not have any facility upgraded yet to level 2, and I'm not sure if it is tracking station. Yes, the tracking station that needs to be upgraded to level 2 in order to be able to time warp to some point. So let's just do it that way until we are near apoapsis. And the delta V in our upper stage, especially if you now deploy the fairing, is quite excessive. So we can put our Staputnik 1 satellite into a somewhat inclined orbit, because there will be more than enough let's activate precision control. There will be more than enough stuff in equatorial orbits in the future. Trying to get it to stabilize it manually About like this. Fire. For some time I actually had the yep, we are in orbit. For some time I actually had the magic plume or real plume mod installed that would have made the rocket exhaust look much different now. So let's extend the antennas just for the looks. They do not serve any purpose, of course. But if we time warp to the day side of Kerbin, and then decouple, it will look like Sputnik 1, or as much as it can look like Sputnik 1 in Kerbal Space Program. So anyway, we have got, well, 170,000 funds. Let's see what the first Bolt's first milestone says. Yes, we have entered orbit. 24,000 funds. That definitely was worth it. And hold on, the contracts. Yeah, I like that. So let's head back to the Space Center, but not without stopping the recording. In order to prevent crashes, which is exactly what happened. And yeah, after that I have taken on another contract to launch a polar satellite, and this file that was corrupted by the game crash literally was only 30 seconds in the mission control and then going to the VAB, so I did not bother to reenact that again. And unfortunately this crash also set my microphone, well, not out of commission, but it was just for some reason not detected anymore, so I'm now commenting this like the in the editing. So yeah, basically my idea was to build or to actually take the auto-saved Stay Putnik from the saved ships, but I think because of Kerbal constructs the ship was not saved. So I've had to build an almost identical again, or not the ship, but the spacecraft. And yeah, I guess that this, because of Kerbal constructs, it has not been autosaved because I just pushed the build button and then later like picked up the readily built ship on the launch pad. And I decided to speed the video up a little by turning this this building into a time lapse. And I kept the original audio because it sounds quite interesting, this VAB music at 4x speed. And so you can see placing the antennas and everything basically identical like I did before. But the big difference that is now coming is the liquid fueled upper stage to allow placing the satellite with a greater precision into its orbit. Because of course I need to put it in a specified inclination, and I then found out that the Terrier engine that I wanted to put there actually has not been unlocked yet. So heading quickly into the research and development department, researching the required tech tree node. Unfortunately I cannot see the name here in the small window in the editor or in the Windows Movie Maker. But yeah, anyway, a couple of days later this required tech tree node is researched and we have the Terrier engine, so we can place it. And again, here comes the VAB music at 4x speed. Now basically building the same kind of rocket as we did before with the Hammer solid rocket motor for small fins, and then the big BACC Thumper with 4 winglets for control. And then again, like placing a name, of course this time accordingly, Stay Putnik 2. and then building the vessel. So here we are, I think it was 15 days building time, I don't know, but you were able, or you should have been able to read it. So here we are at the launch pad. Again, there is no SAS to be activated, but the staging looks good. And yeah, now this time we are of course not going to launch eastwards like we did before, because if we launched eastwards and then wanted to change the inclination, so here we lift off to actually going into the polar orbit, we would waste really ludicrous amount of delta V for doing that. So instead we launch southwards, pitching up instead of yawing to the right. And the reason that I selected launching southwards and northwards is just because south of the Kerbal Space Center there is only oceans for hundreds and hundreds of kilometers. So we can just drop off our spent rocket stages without having to think about hitting someone, of course only hypothetically, because the only things you can find in Kerbal Space Program are the few launch sites, except for that the planet is completely empty. So now staging to the second stage, and it is being stable by its aerodynamic fins that are similar to the previous launch, getting quite hot. Now, and yeah, I think it's, yeah, there it goes. The aerodynamic effects with this ionized gas from the compression heat suddenly disappear for, well, the reasons that are clear in the space program. And we are now, yeah, the hammer has burned out. And the inclination already looks good. I think it was something like 83 degrees and required is an inclination between 85 and 95 degrees. So we only have to do a small, only give it a little nudge, a little more nudge into southward direction to put it into the required orbit. And yeah, so there you can see the inclined and eccentrical orbit of, oh no, you cannot see it anymore, the orbit of Stay Put 1. And there goes the second stage. Was dropped off, but like the second final stage was opening this this aerodynamic fairing and activating the Terrier engine is not activated yet, but it is now. And yeah, again manually holding the vessel stable and pointing in the right direction. It's actually not that hard with the precision controls. So, and firing this Terrier engine until we have reached the required inclination and of course have reached orbit, which should happen right now. I can see the noise level I can see here in the editor, and of course when the noise level suddenly drops I know that an engine is cut off. I think I already mentioned that I'm using the Windows Movie Maker for editing, because it is just so darn easy to operate, and extending the antennas again that do not serve any purpose other than cosmetical and jettisoning the uppermost stage. And yeah, this completes our second Stay Putnik satellite in polar orbit, and also concludes this fifth episode of my Kerbal Space Program videos. And I do not know yet what I am going to do in the next episode. Maybe some more satellite or probe related stuff, or maybe some more things for my manned space program, which again will be some atmospheric flying for the pilots, because of course there's still a lot of science that can be done with airplanes. So anyway, if you liked it, you can feel free to like and leave a subscription, and also check out my other channel, the main channel, and I hope to see you again in the next video of this series.